I'm running a bit early tonight. How is everybody? Well done, Lou. Superman 3. That was the scene where the giant computer pulls in the... I can't remember the actress's name, and turns her into some sort of half computer, half robot. You know what? Growing up as a kid, that scene freaked me out, and I don't know why. But obviously since then, as you mentioned in there, we've had Borg attacks and everything. So, but it was a scary film back then. As a matter of fact, hello, Christopher Grantham.
Let's give it up big time. Hello, Christian from Grantham. Now let's get cracking.
See, now, I think the fear did drop away when 7 and 9 came along. It was replaced by another feeling. I'm not quite sure what that feeling was, but it's all good. It's all good. I've got a happy birthday tonight, and I haven't wrote it down, so I'm hoping I can remember the name. Paul Tidd was 38 yesterday, so happy birthday, Paul Tidd. I only remember that because I went to school with someone called Stanley Tidd. So... I said to Mrs. Wilder Wayne, I'm sure I can remember that, and I'm glad I have, because we've done it straight away. Now, you know how we, on this channel and in the community, we like to help other channels out? Well, I did mention it to the Patreons yesterday, but we're trying to get Jason Stevenson of Mr. Fusion Designs to 1,000 subscribers. I think he's on about 660 at the moment. Now, if you don't know Jason, Mr. Fusion Designs, his latest mod... is the screens and stuff for the Knight Rider car, which is absolutely brilliant. And I do have a link. And I'm going to post that in chat, that you can go over there and subscribe. As I said, we're trying to get him to 1,000 subscribers. When he's at 1,000 subscribers, his channel can then be monetized, you see. So that's why it's a big deal when you're doing the final push. And I'm only just too happy to help... the community to try and get to those epic figures. So it's really good. But I have put the link in chat there, and I'll probably post it again later on just so you can see that. Yesterday on the Patreon channel, we built this lovely Marvel. We're just talking about flying saucers before the stream started today. So I thought I'd give you a quick treat today, and I'll get this lit again. There's already alcohol in there. There's already water in there, and I've already got the fire. No fire extinguishers. All I've got, if there is a fire... is this tiny cup of water with the syringe inside that I use to fill the thing up. So hopefully that can save us if everything goes our way. Now, today I did the Titanic, which I thought I had four stages for, but I only had two, which was quite lucky because I managed to get a video out. But I was going to do the Volvo tomorrow, but I'm not going to get time. I'm picking the kiddies up tomorrow. And May for me is quite a busy month because all of my children have birthdays in May. So it's my son Jack. His is on Saturday. Then my daughter, Faith, hers is on the 21st. Riley's on the 23rd. And then Charlotte's on the 30th. So I don't know what it is with me planning families and May, but it's just a busy month for me. So what I'm going to do tomorrow is I'm actually going to be editing Mrs. Wilder Wayne's video that's going up on Saturday. So there'll be no video on the channel tomorrow. So on Saturday, you will see Mrs. Wilder Wayne's. I can give you a shout out for your birthday on Monday the 9th. As a matter of fact, I'm not going to be streaming. So, David, I can either wish you happy birthday now, in which case I can put the little thing up there and say, happy birthday, David Marshall, for Monday. There won't be a stream. It's probably best to do it now because there's not going to be a stream on Tuesday because I'm going to be watching the new Marvel, what's his little name? Doctor Strange. Now, my daughter went to see it this afternoon. No, there's going to be no spoilers here. I've just heard... yeah, that's what I've heard about it. Yeah, that was her review. Yeah. Now, I was going to let you know what's going on as well in May. Now, as you know, at the end of the month, I'm going to be going to America, and we've got loads of things planned. And we're obviously culminating in the Wonderfest convention festival in Louisville on the 2nd of June, is it? 2nd, 3rd of June, the beginning of June. Looking forward to that. And I know some of you from the States are going to be over there. Thank you, Ian. That's appreciated. We're gonna have Faith here for her birthday this year. I won't have Riley this year, but that is really appreciated. And you know that now I've told them that they're gonna be bugging me big time for things to get. They're addicted to this Oculus Quest thing that they're watching. For that reason, sorry, I'm making myself laugh. Spruverse and Mrs. Spruverse have created an amazing itinerary for our trip to America, and. Earlier on, Phil gave me a script of what to say of what we're doing. But you know me, I want to do my own thing. So I made this little two-minute snippet about the itinerary that we're going to be doing when we go to America at the end of the month. Hope you like this. So let me give you an insight to our itinerary. Me and Mrs. World Away, we're going to head off to Heathrow Airport, Terminal 5, and we'll be flying out to Washington, D.C., where we're going to meet Mr. Spruverse and later on Mrs. Spruverse. Have a little few days in Washington and soak up all the sights before heading down, driving to Williamsburg. In Colonial Williamsburg, which is a living history place, but they'll already know we're coming because someone warned them ahead that the redcoats are coming. We're going to be going from Williamsburg and driving down. It's actually going to be a pilgrimage, this one, to North Carolina, where we're going to visit the lovely city of Raleigh. And hopefully there, our pilgrimage is going to continue to meet the almighty headquarters of Aztec Dummy. So we'll meet Lou there. We're going to be driving then to Charlotte. And then from Charlotte, we're going to be finally arriving at our main destination, which is Louisville, where the Wonderfest Festival is happening. And as you see, it seems to have a Wrath of Khan theme, which is going to be quite interesting. We have to say goodbye to Mrs. World of Wayne then, because she has to return back to work. So we're packing off her suitcases and throwing her out on a plane to Chicago, and then she's going back to London. But myself, Phil and Mrs. Spruverse, we're going to be heading down to Dallas, and then we're going to be going on to LAX, LA, which is a first for me. I can't wait for that. And I promised Mrs. World of Wayne we wouldn't do anything fun, so, you know, there's nothing in LA that I really want to see. I'm gonna have to keep it on the down low, but yeah, we'll be going to the Warner Brothers studio, the Pizza Museum. I'm gonna help Phil out with his PCs and work. Hopefully we'll be streaming from Phil's workshop. I know I'm not gonna want to come home, but that I must do. So back to LAX and then back home. But what an adventure, huh? That's something that we've got coming up in, I don't know, approximately 23 days. You know what, Phil? When I was just pulling pictures for that, just randomly, I just typed Spruverse into Google and put an image search, and that picture I put of you with your computer was the first picture that came up on Google search. I thought that was quite funny. Got to check out Utah. No, definitely, definitely. I said I just had visitors from Utah come and visit me a couple of days ago, which was excellent. So Nigel T, it's your birthday on Monday. Let me put the little birthday thing up. Now you're a special birthday. You're 21. You're 21 in, like, you know, senior years. So you are now 21. Because when I'm 60, I'm going to feel like I'm 21 again. We've got a lot of you peeps turning 60 this year. It's going to be a good year. I turn 50 next year. So I'm still the baby, but, you know, not long. Oh, you got your card. Oh, no problems. Thank you for that. I'm glad you got that. And there are cards on the way to Howard. I don't know. Who did we send them to? My PA handled that for me. So she did really good. Fun in Chicago airport. Don't talk to strangers. I'm sure Mrs. World of Wayne's going to be fine. But every time I hear Chicago, I just keep thinking of the 1930s and Al Capone. I'm sure it's gone on a long way. Or Elliot Ness, you know. That's Chicago to me. But we're all cool. World of Wayne, I don't think I can make Wonderfest. Oh, no. But I'd like to catch up with you and Phil in LA, perhaps. Well, we're there. I think I'm in LA for 5 days, is it, Phil? Something like that? From Monday to Saturday? I don't know, unless they change the things. But we'll have to see when I'm out there. I'm like fluid. I'm like liquid. And talking about liquid, tonight I'm drinking the... this is pretty strong stuff. Shepherd Neame and Co. 1698 Kentish Strong Ale. And it's 6.5%. For me, you see, I've been hurt. Behave. Stop talking. Alexa, stop. I need to, there you go, that's better. I need to build up my constitution because, I know I drink drinks on stream and I'm drinking rum and stuff like that, but I don't drink a lot. I really don't. So that one rum's enough to get me completely whammed. Things that have been going on in the workshop this week. I will catch up with chat in a minute, I promise. Obviously, you saw, let me get rid of that happy birthday sign now. You saw me do the seat part of Ian's bike, the Ducati, which is looking absolutely brilliant. What you didn't know, which I did tell the patrons yesterday, is that when I had this, I put it back over here. And as I did so, I whacked the front section of the Orca off. The whole section here fell off. So half of my day yesterday was putting it back together. So the good thing is that, it's now back together perfectly. The gutting thing is, if you remember, I missed the little frame that goes on the bow section of the ship. I could have probably put that on. Now I knew that that came off. So, oh well, it is what it is. No use crying over spilt milk, as they say. So, hello, Adrian. How's it going? Oh, I just saw someone else there as well. It's been a lovely day today, Will's Workshop. You know what? We've just got the address label on your plaque, so that's going to be posted out shortly. Plus, all those peeps that won last week. Did I say last week? When did I announce it? On Tuesday stream. So we've got Robert Beveridge, Chris Morris, and Anthony Oates. I've seen you in chat already, Anthony. Your stuff's going to be posted off next week. I don't want you to think that I've posted it already. I haven't had a chance yet to get that off. So that's where you're going. Are you going to the pit? Yes. Peter Museum. Oh, is the tar pits next to it? I didn't know that. Trevor, when I think of LA, I randomly think of places which I've seen on movies or TV programs. Like the tar pits I know from The Simpsons with the whole doe a deer, a female deer thing. But yeah, I didn't know that. But Peterson Museum, definitely, because we've there's a Bond in Motion exhibition going on there, I believe, at the moment. And the Warner Brothers studio, I mean, you've got to film a studio tour. Oh, I love a studio tour. Martin, I'm jealous of my trip. I just can't wait. I'm as giddy as a school. Esther's got like an advent calendar on her phone. So if you ask Esther how many days left, she'll tell you. Esther's probably not going to be on stream much tonight because she's actually doing some work for a school at the moment. So she's inside marking. So tonight I've got free reign to just say what I want, I guess. Because she ain't going to hear. I am the 8-hole. I am going to be catching some regional Pokemon. And then I'll be trading them when I come back here. That's the thing, isn't it? Regional Pokemon. We'll be in the airport doing it. I'm doing good, Roger. How are you? Your birthday was April 26th. We missed it. Oh, and how old was you, Troy? Happy birthday from April 26th. Oh, you are online, damn it. I'm going to shop. That'd be a 6-hour drive to Wandsworth if I had time and money, which is neither at that moment. The thing is, I'm going to it as a complete virgin. I don't know what to expect. But stepping soil is just stepping foot on American soil after 12 years. That's the last time I went to America. It's just, it's going to blow my mind. It's going to be one of those surreal moments. You're in the airport, not realizing that you're in a completely different continent. As a matter of fact, it's the first time that me and Mrs. Welder Wayne have been on a plane together. It's the first time, apart from Scotland, that we've been abroad together. So this is there's a lot of firsts on this trip. But we are looking so looking forward to this. The Orca should be in a case. It should be, but I like it there. I like the whole Steven Spielberg thing going on. And I am going to be putting something here when the Ecto-1 goes off to Svi. So not long there. Now, I think... I did. Have you seen... I did see the new Obi-Wan trailer, Adrian James. Looks pretty good, actually. I saw The Last Moon Knight. I didn't think much of that, I have to say. It started off good, and then it sort of petered out. So, yeah. Not my cup of tea. The reins are off. No, they're not. I just saw her in here. Look, I'm here, you idiot. Oh, dear. Hello, John's Model Making. How's it going? So I think, before we start, do they allow virgins on Wonderfest? Why, they're vampires there. That could be good. You know what, Phil? We're big Lost Boys fans. We love the Lost Boys. Now, I don't know where is it, where Santa Clara was filmed, and the pier and all of that there. I don't know where that was filmed, but I don't think we could go there because Mrs. Weldaway would kill me if I've been there. There's a couple of places I've always wanted to see. There's a beach as well where Mr. Miyagi's doing the crane technique. It was the same beach that was used in the film The Craft with Robin Tunney and Fairuza Balk. I don't know where that is. If that's near you, that could be fun. Oops, I'm moving my camera around here. You know me, I'm like, I don't know what to do, and I'm probably going to come with a big list, Phil. But I can't wait to get into Phil's workshop, I have to say. And we're going to have a look at his setup with his computer system as well, which is going to be cool. It is a requirement, is it? Thank God for that. Have I got to wear a sign or something, you know, to say I won the best virgin? I could get some t-shirts printed for that. I really enjoyed Moon Knight, don't get me wrong, but I don't think it's finished as strong as it started. I think that was the problem with it. It's been delayed, Reese Westwood, just so you know. I have seen it from the Diecast Club, but it's been delayed. There's no release date at the moment, so... okay, so what I'm going to do, before I read any more chat, is I want to start a fire, because I don't know if this alcohol's have started to evaporate already. So this is the flying saucer that we had before. And what happens is, let me just light this. We put water in the top here. It puts it in this basin. The basin heats up and there's vents at the side of the UFO, which should drive it round like a steam engine. Now, this at the top is a little bit like a pressure cooker. So the pressure can't build up too much in there. Otherwise, it will just blow up in my face. So that will come up if the pressure gets too much. So theoretically, when that gets hot enough, it should start up. And the sound it makes really does sound like a steam engine, which I'm going to try and demonstrate for you with my microphone when it decides that it wants to work. I don't know how much water's in there, to be honest with you. But we will see. I know because there's some drips on the top and they're going to start heating up. But you can see that okay, can't you? Let me just move it a tiny bit closer. There you go. This is where it doesn't work. I haven't used it since yesterday, but I'm just still captivated by it. Not doing much, is it? Come on. Boil the water. God, it's like waiting for a kettle to boil. Now, obviously, because it's got vent holes, I'll be able to see the steam escaping from the side. I can smell it. It did this a lot quicker last night, didn't it? Who thought you'd tune into a stream where you're just watching a... I'll come back to that, I think. I don't know if you can see that through the main camera. It's not doing much anything. I'll keep chatting until it starts moving. Oh, actually, it's making a noise. Stand by. Oh, here we go. It's going. Look. Oh, it moved a bit. Come on. Oh, there we go. Here it goes. And look, I'm going to put this close to it. You can hear the steam. I mean, it sounds like a steam engine. I'm captivated by stupid stuff like that, I tell you. Well, I might as well let that do what it's doing. I'm sure the alcohol is probably going to burn itself out, or it's going to run out of water. One of the two things that happen. But that's from Sterling Kit. If you want to get yourself one, I think it's about £32. But it's just a novel. I like novelties. And they do one in there for, I think, $139, which is actually attached to a nodding donkey. So you have a UFO spinning while a nodding donkey is going up and down. The sort of thing that you'd expect to find in the landscapes of America. UFOs and nodding donkeys. There you go. I've just summed up America in one go. Moon Knight was very strange. It was, but I've heard Doctor Strange is strange as well. My daughter described it as an acid trip. They're in DC, are they? The stairs for The Exorcist. I didn't know that. Where are the stairs from Laurel and Hardy? You know, with a piano. That's somewhere, isn't it? I know it's all built up now and the stairs are enclosed by houses and stuff. I do like the history of thing. I mean, now if you've seen Phil Spruverse Instagram, he's actually working on a Laurel and Hardy figurines at the moment in a 4T car. I did show that off on the stream from Infinite Statues or something, wasn't it? I think they're a German company. When growing up, I love Laurel and Hardy. My favourite episode, can't remember the name of it, was the one where they were going through the sawdust extractor. They're working in a lumber mill, I think it was. It was that's my favourite. But I was brought up on Laurel and Hardy. In the UK, the BBC used to show Laurel and Hardy. I think it was about between half five and six before the news. And you'd either be watching Laurel and Hardy, or if you remember Harold Lloyd, you'd be watching old Harold Lloyd movies. I am really showing my age now, aren't I? Get ready to reset the axe on the ball. We were saying that yesterday, Will. Ian Half going fast, though. Check that out. Look. Wow. I don't know if I'm meant to blow it out or just let it run to fruition. It is basically a whole engine on its side, but it just makes a cool noise. I like that. And for a couple of bits of metal, I mean, it's all metal, to be honest with you. And it took about 15 minutes on the Patreon stream to put it together. But I take care, Meganico. See you later. But, you know, it seemed like we were having this UFO theme before the stream started today. You know, what films are there with saucer or flying saucer in the title? Not many. Fire! Oh, Beavis and Butthead. Fire! when I went to Universal LA, they were filming Sequest. God, that must have been a time ago. Steve? Wow. I mean, they've got obviously the Hill Valley set there. That's going to be good. The last time I went to Universal, I went to Universal in Florida. They had the Lost World, I think it was. And they had some of the Jurassic Park vehicles from the Lost World there. That was a long time ago. Was that 2000 and... God, it might be 97. 97. I've been in America in 97, 2002, 2003 and 2007. So, oh, and then I went to Vegas in 2009 and 2007. So, I'm going to blow this out now because I can smell those alcohol fumes and I don't know if that's a good thing or not. If I pass out on stream, you know why? A watch pot never boils. Yeah, you see? I swear, you were so good. Yeah, I don't think my insurance company going to accept that, Steve. While working in my workshop, a UFO that I was building at the time came alive and set fire to it. Paint dry next segment. I was going to make it a feature. Can you imagine 24 hours of paint drying just with my dulcet tones? Bit like Bob Ross, you know? We'll get our moisturometer on this now and see how far it's dried. I don't know if it's one of the ultimate compliments you can get as a YouTuber that people say that they watch me to go to sleep to. I've got a soothing voice. It's either that or I'm just so incredibly boring. I did, yeah. The what was it? It is working. But I like gadgets though. If I easily tie, I love a gadget. That's the thing. You know, in the UK we got a shop called the Gadget Shop. It's closed down now. I think it became Hawkins Bazaar or Red 5 or something like that. But yeah, I'm always looking for a gadget. This is why you've got to watch me in America, Phil, because I'll just have my suitcase full of toot. It does sound like a locomotive, doesn't it? Is it weird? You're doing Esther's. They don't take that long, Graham. We've got our Esther sorted out. Everything to go to America is sorted. The only thing we've got to do now is pack our bags. And then, obviously, we've got the curveball that they throw in now, where we've got to get a rapid antigen test the day before our flight. So I'm doing one where I can do it from home, but someone's going to be watching me and talking me through it. But it's a bit of a pain. It's in Burbank, is it, those steps? All right. I've seen a picture of it, what it looks like today, but with the... there's so many houses around it now. But is America like... I don't think it is. Sorry, Phil, you might be able to answer this. See, in the UK, if somewhere's been filmed as a location and it's well known, you get the blue plaques that they put up on the building to say, you know, this is where something was filmed or why it's a site of significance. But, you know, do they do that in LA? I haven't got a clue. That's my favourite one. Yeah, I do love it. Is that Busybodies, is it? I think Busybodies was what Phil's model is from. Uh, We could check out Doctor... Really? How long before we get arrested for, like, stalking people? I liked the look of... I was looking at Mulholland Drive because I don't know if you know, Phil, I mentioned it. I think it was on Wednesday stream. I was having a rewatch of Close Encounters. Absolutely love that film. And I was wondering if the scene where they're overlooking the city in Close Encounters, where the UFOs, where they see him for the first time, go off, is the same scene that they filmed in E.T. looking over the city. So through research, from what I understand, that what you think is the valley in E.T. is actually a miniature. But I'm guessing that's kind of like what the landscape looks like. So then I was thinking, if that's on Mulholland Drive, which I think is a 21-mile road in the mountains, isn't it? I'm not sure. But is there a viewpoint that has that view, I wonder? Or is it just movie magic and that scene doesn't exist? I don't know. There's a lot of Laurel and Hardy fans. What did you think of the movie? Have anyone seen the movie with the latest movie that came out about 4 years ago? I kind of like that as well. The Laurel and Hardy stairs are also in Pasadena. Wow. It's also where John Carpenter's Halloween was filmed. See, all these filming locations. In the UK, there'd be blue plaques everywhere. I haven't, no. But the one of them was comes from Ulverston. I know there's a statue there, Will. Fednose Street got a plaque there. All right, wow. Will Hayes was beyond his time, definitely. But yeah, I used to like the Laurel and Hardy films. I mean, it's funny because I was brought up with Laurel and Hardy and Harold Lloyd. Around about that time, they weren't showing any Charlie Chaplin films. So Charlie Chaplin was completely unknown to me. It was just Laurel and Hardy and Harold Lloyd until far later on, which is a bit weird. You'd expect that Charlie Chaplin would have been the bigger draw. I suppose it's what the TV companies were syndicated to show at the time. I believe we are doing a VIP tour and the War of the Worlds sets. Wow. I'm going to be buzzing. When I get excited for something, you probably see when I start working on the Orca, I could be a little bit, what's the word? I could be a little bit, I can't describe it. Mrs. Welder Wayne's probably got the word for you. And I can get emotional as well. So you got to watch out for that. I can get very emotional sometimes. So, I mean, when I saw pandas at Edinburgh Zoo, I had tears streaming down my face. Mrs. Welder Wayne will tell you, I've always wanted to see a panda for real. Where was the other one? Seeing the SR-71 at Duxford. I mean, it's a plane. It's an inanimate object. But I'm getting upset seeing it for the first time. Imagine what it's going to be like seeing a space shuttle. yeah, you might want to... Let me block user. There we go. I had a Facebook message then come up. So apparently just trying to sell me something. If I dial a number. No idea. But his name was Dr. Kenneth. So, you know, must be true. Yeah, when the car was split in part. But that was the same episode as well. Because didn't it go for a bandsaw? I'm sure it was in the lumber mill that happened. You've decided to use an Arduino Nano to control the Ecto-1s. I'm not happy with the board provided. Anthony, I'm going to have a go at doing the Arduino again. I need to order some more parts. Because there are some bits that I want to work on. I've got some projects lined up soon. So, no plaques. They're awful about memorializing anything to do with film. Shameful. It's crazy. You'd think the home of movies would celebrate more. It's I don't know. But then I suppose with movies being made in LA and Hollywood all the time, if there's blue plaques everywhere, it's just more to edit out in scenes that you don't want them in. But it is funny. I was never really... Growing up, I loved the films. But then when I got to about teenage years, I liked the behind-the-scenes stuff, the location, the cinematography, the writing. And that's what I got into. And the there was a site. I don't know if it's out now. I think it's called Fast Forward Rewind or something. And what the guy would do is he'd take a film, and The Karate Kid was one of the films he took, and he would take a still from the film and then obviously go to that location and take the exact still as it looks now. And he did loads of movies like that. It wasn't just The Karate Kid. And I know there's some people on the internet that do that now. But it is interesting to see how things have just completely changed, big time. And as you say, that if something's so iconic, then, you know, there's no preservation orders in or something like that. Don't know. Hello, Craig, how's it going? Was that shot in a soundstage as well? So does that scene never exist then? I just like the whole idea of being up. I mean, I think there is some places on Mulholland. Every time I say that film, I just keep thinking of Jennifer Connelly and David Lynch. I'm sure there's a scene up there that looks over LA, but I could be wrong. But it doesn't look anything like what we see in E.T. But yeah, I've been having a bit of a Spielberg rewatch lately. But I said, but it's just amazing how I didn't even think about it before. But with Close Encounters, that scene at the end with the spaceship and the guy on the piano and they're communicating with music, it just reminds me so much of Deliverance with the dueling banjos. That's, to me, what's going on. And I do wonder if the inspiration for some films is that's where it come from. But it's good. It wasn't until I saw... what film did I see recently? I watched The Time Machine. And then the old Time Machine. And they had the references from that I can now see in the Back to the Future film. The crossing the road and almost getting run over by a car and stuff like that. So it's interesting. Very interesting. When I hear UFO, I think of the Disney movie Flight of the Navigator. First UFO movie I saw growing up. Steve, I've never seen it. I've never seen Flight of the Navigator. I know about it. I've seen the advert, but I've never seen it. So I like Space Camp. Launch Max into space. They filmed the party scene that's in Barn on Scream 5 around the corner from me. Oh, really? Oh, my God. There's a signpost by the stairs. Like the signpost we get for walks around the UK. Obsessive. That's a good word. Obsessive. The words tonight that we're categorizing me, Lou. Obsessive and virgin so far. Obsessed. Oh, dear. Phil, you've got no idea what you let yourself in for. I don't know. We'll have to go on the Jaws ride. I'll be, woo! See, I mean, there's a sight, Pete, just seeing the SCA space shuttle on the back of the 747. I've only ever seen it in model form. And you know what? I've still got to do the decals on that. Perhaps that could be one of the Tuesday builds. Putting decals on. Because I started and I haven't finished. Did you notice that I found the back, actually? I don't know if Nick Barmer's in here. I found the back. I thought that was missing. So I've put that on to protect the engines at the moment. I'm going to try something. It's getting really hot in here because we've had a hot day. I'm going to turn the aircon on. I don't know if that's going to affect sound. Hopefully not. And you can still hear me okay. I heard about that, Ian, to be honest with you. Do you think Spielberg should put the interior shot of the Close Encounters mothership back in? I didn't even know there was one. I like... Sometimes in a film, The Ralph, it's what you don't see, which leaves up to your imagination, which I think it makes it better. I think that's why so many of the old horror movies work better now than seeing all the graphic gore and the CGI. I do like the whole, you know, you're using a little bit of, oh my God, sort of thing. They tried to get some of that with, trying to think of the name of the kill, Cloverfield. You don't actually see the monster until the end. The problem with Cloverfield is the camera shaking. I could, like, my screen, look, that's what the camera was like on Cloverfield. I can't watch films like that. They make me feel seasick. Wayne, if you can, you should go to the Indy 500 Museum. It's in Speedway in from Louisville, a straight drive on Highway 65 to the 465 East and exit on Speedway. I've never been into the IndyCar, you know, Gunny. I went to Vegas, and at the time the Sahara had a big IndyCar thing going on. But I mean, we've got the F1 and the Grand Prix here. I've never got the fascination of just going around a track. You saw a transformer blow up a couple of... Are we talking like robots? Or are we talking like electrical terminals? I'm guessing you're talking about a power conduit station and not a Terminator. I need to activate captions. I don't know how I do that. You have to take Wayne out to Vasquez Rocks. Oh, I know Vasquez Rocks. One of us can dress up like a Gorn. It'll be like the Big Bang Theory. No plaque outside Lord Brett Sinclair's London flat. They just put things up all the time. This was Charles Dickens' birthplace. Charles Dickens went to school here. Charles Dickens had dinner here. Around York, Phil, you were talking earlier with us. If you haven't been to York, York is great for Viking stuff. You've got the Jorvik Centre there. And they found a lot of Viking stuff there. They got a ride. Ian's just come back from York and bought a Viking sword. So if you're ever in the UK again, I'll take you to York. And we'll do York my way. York was voted, I think, the best city to visit with the greatest nightlife in the UK. Which beat London. So that's crazy. You were in a Redux version of Superman 4? It was originally filmed in Milton Keynes and the Redux was filmed in the same buildings. Oh my God. I think I've only seen Superman 4 once. It wasn't... I hated the film. But, you know, Superman 3 is one of my favourites. Superman 2 was good, but I did prefer the Richard Donner cut than the original with the Eiffel Tower and all of that. I didn't really like that. Nah, never seen Flight of the Navigator. But isn't that Vasquez Rocks in the middle of nowhere? It's like in the desert, isn't it? How far is LA from the desert? It can't be that far. Hi James, how's it going? Sata's models. Like I can say Sata just rolling off the tongue now. Do you remember when you first joined the channel? I couldn't say it. I'm so happy with myself. And that's what Spielberg says, but when I saw it, I can't forget it. Really? Yeah, stop changing movies. I do like the films where you leave things to the imagination. I just think the films are better that way. Take care, Lou. See you later, mate. The Goonies was filmed in Oregon. Oh my God. Well, I know Short Circuit was filmed in Oregon. And I know you can rent the house out. I've said that before. It's an Airbnb now that Ali Sheedy stayed in. John, we love York. Been to York a few times. We did the City Cruise, City Walk. Walked around the City Wall. Went down the Shambles, Stonegate. Went in the Evil Eye Gin Shop. But we've never done the Ghost Walk. That's something we want to do. But me and Mrs. Wold, getting old, we couldn't stay up that late. We're gonna make sure that we do in America. You got really good at it. Yeah, Sata, you see, it just flows off the tongue. No, I've seen the one where he goes inside up to the spaceship. I haven't seen him go in it. But, I mean, there's so many different cuts. It's about 45 minutes drive. Wow. They must get lots of visitors, though. Vasquez Rocks? I don't know. It's like the Vegas sign. I walked past Mandalay Bay to see the Vegas sign, not realising that it's like another mile past Mandalay Bay. And when I got there, I just thought we're just going to see a sign. I'll have my picture taken with it. And they have massive queues of people waiting to have their picture taken with the LA sign, Las Vegas sign. You don't see that in the brochures. Speaking of robots, I'm ready for one of those model companies to do a build a number 5 Short Circuit. I think it's well overdue, Steve. They need to build, and I'd say a half scale. I don't think you'd be building a full scale. But they're... dinner time, Lou. There is a guy in Nottingham who's built a full-size Johnny 5. I'm hoping to catch him at one of the conventions that are coming up. There's the London Film and Comic Con. There's quite a few this year. There's Collectomania. I think there's a Comic Con in Glasgow. I'm hoping to catch him so I can show you all what his number 5 looks like. It looks really good, to be honest with you. Stephanie! Jerk of the well, turkey, pain in the ass. Vasquez rocks in pink eyes, been well filmed. How am I doing tonight? Let's have a look. 37. Oh, I'm really, really keeping up with chat tonight. I said to Mrs. Wilderwayne, I'll try my best. Oh, Short Circuit and Goonies was the same town, James Boy. I had no idea. Wow. Wow. But you know, you just have to rent that house. I'd love to. Let me stand by. Oops, my computer just went a bit weird. Hopefully I'm still online. Yep, good. So scenic sunsets at the Short Circuit House. It's in a place called, Phil, you'll probably know this, Astoria in Oregon. Let me go to that one. Does that work? There we go. Look. So you can stay at the house with the bridge there. Look. I just think it'd be great to stay in a location. Four guests, two bedrooms, two beds, two bathrooms. Richard owns it. He's a super host, apparently. But yeah, Airbnb. How cool is that? So it does exist. Mad. The NRM. What's the NRM? I'm stupid. What is the NRM? Astoria, not sure your spelling. Astoria, it says here, Oregon. I don't know where that is. If I click on it, does it give me a map? Oh, there we go. Look, so let me go back over here. We've got a map. So that's where it is. So there's Oregon. So it's the north side. Look, it's just on the borders of Washington, actually. Wow. It's all the way up there. Might as well go to Vancouver while we're at it. Bless. You had a shipment of Ghostbusters today. Yeah, here we go. Look, hadn't had one since November last year, part 67 and 70. All I know, Shane, is that you're in America, Shane, I guess, yeah? Is that some of the stuff's coming out. The Enterprise is coming out. The Ecto-1's coming out. I think they're behind with the Eleanor as well. But I don't know what's happening. I haven't got a clue. All I do know at the moment, and this accounts for everyone, is that the Shenzhen province in China has recently been shut down for, I think, 3 weeks. Now, the Chinese had a zero policy, so it is complete lockdown. So why that's happening? No work's happened, and while no work happens, no products are coming in, no shipments are going out, nothing's being made. And that's why you're experiencing delays at the moment, and you'll find that's probably across everyone at the moment. So the stuff we're getting now is what's been sent out before that lockdown, but that's going to affect everybody worldwide, and They can't answer when you're going to get it because they don't know. So it's a bad time. I mean, it's a great time to build partworks because when people were furloughed and stuff, obviously they had something to do. But it's a bad time trying to get the partworks made because everyone was in the same boat. And I do think that at the moment, the world's still in the recovery room. And sometimes I do think it needs a bit of shocking to get it back to the way it was, because at the end of the day, we've got to get back to the way it was eventually. When that happens, who knows? But hopefully things will settle down soon. Already in the UK, when I fly back from America, I haven't got to do any COVID tests or anything. Watch the Eagle Has Landed, then go to the village where it's filmed. It's good. Lord Brett Sinclair, The Persuaders. I haven't seen that film for years, Nigel T. Oh, there we go. You know Astoria. 3 hours drive from Portland. There we go. God. You know, on a map, that looks tiny, but that's 3 hours. Wow. That whole west coast of America does look like a fun little journey, I have to say. What's that? Oh, Tijuana. I keep winding Mrs. Worldwayne up about Tijuana. South of the border. Now Mexico way. Hello, John. I see John's iconic builds had Spitfire problems out. I'm very impressed how he's cut the base down. I was going to do that, John, on mine, but I don't know if you heard, but the Spitfire's knackered for me. I got about the same as John. I had 4 flights out of it. Then the lifter jammed up. So I changed the lifter. I fixed it so it went down, and then the next time it went straight up again. So I thought, I've got a faulty switch. So I just switched my lifters around, and then the other one did exactly the same. And when I went back to the circuit board, I've got a little blowout on one of my chips. So the Spitfire works, the propellers go round. As a matter of fact, it does everything. It'll even take off, but it won't bank and it won't lift up and down now. So I have ordered another motherboard, control board, but I'm giving it to my dad, and my dad's really in the advanced stages of Parkinson's. He can't use a remote control. So I think I'm just going to give it him as a static model, which is a pain because I've read the Facebook groups. I'm not oblivious to it, and I've seen so many people with problems. And to get those problems this far into the build, were these problems caused because we had to go back and change the circuit board? Because some people went back and changed the gears? I don't know. I haven't got a clue. But it's not very good. The only hope that I've got is the Zero Fighter has gone together perfectly after Pack 1 and 2. It's gone together perfectly. So I'm hoping that I can get the same effect with that. We'll see what happens. But again, I'm still waiting for box 11. There's two more boxes left of that now. So I'm still waiting for 11 and 12. Are you in the UK? Oh, right. I didn't realise. You are right, Shane. You are in the UK. Yeah, I remember now. My mind ain't what it used to be. Oh, date hole. You're building DeLorean, issue 91. Watch my video first. Then fast forward to issue 99, I think it was, and see how aged I have and how ill I was afterwards. Issue 91 had me in tears. And that was one of those videos that took me all day, trying to piece the thing together. I was just so grateful that the Ecto won together a lot more smoothly. I am going to America, and we head off on the 28th, I think it is, of May. So the rest of my family is going to be staying here looking after things for us. You've been to Mexico. You've been everywhere, Mrs. Wilder Wayne. You're the most world traveller. You're like blimmin' Willy Fogg, the amount of places you've been. Stay away from Tijuana. You'll catch the clap just by sitting in a chair. Really? Again, I only know Tijuana from The Simpsons. The Simpsons give the impression that Tijuana is a place that, like, you know, if we want to go to London for a really good night out or something, or down to Brighton or Portsmouth, that's what Tijuana sounds like to me. It's a place you go just to get completely out of your mind. Everyone's been to Mexico. What? I've never been there. Hello, Roy. How's it going? You went to Basingstoke once. There's not a lot in Basingstoke. I think I drove through Basingstoke once because the M3 was closed. So I had to go through the town. Nightmare on Elm Street, the Back to the Future house. I mean, some of these, yeah, but that's like a normal civvy house, isn't it? What's it like if you hire your house out to a film company to use, knowing that that's now immortalized on film, and any day you could have someone coming up to your house and taking pictures of it? Because I guess it happens. I've seen it in London around Notting Hill Way, that people are taking pictures of the place where David and Sister Hobbs live in American Wealth in London. They're taking pictures of it. Me and Mrs. Wilder Wayne, when we went to Wow's last year, were trying to find the outside of the Slaughtered Lamb pub. But in the Brecon Beacons, the road was closed, so we never got to see it. But that's what we're like. Not released the video yet. Needs a lot of editing. Ah, right, okay. How much as a YouTuber would you earn in a year? Well, you need to get to 1,000 subscribers first, Ryan. And then once you've done that, you need 4,000 hours, and then you'll be monetized. Just because you're monetized doesn't mean you'll get revenue on each and every video. It all depends on how they allocate the video revenue to your channel. And that's based on something called CPM, which is cost per 1,000 views. And depending on what revenue they've got to share between your channel depends on what you work. So for a 10,000 view video, won't pay the same amount if you had another 10,000 view video, if that makes sense. And I can't give you an idea of how much you get paid for each video because of that reason. It changes. I don't think my dad's going to try CBD oil. My dad lost... It's a funny story. I'm sure you don't mind me. He had this fascination with changing phones. So he would take SIM cards out of one phone and put it in another. And when I got round there, he must have had about six phones all on the go with a SIM card that he's lost. And then when we did find it ripping the place apart, I'm trying to put it in a phone, and none of these phones have now got SIM holders anymore. God knows where they went. So these are the sort of things that we deal with. He does see the funny side of it, bless him. But, I mean, we took him out today. My mum's just had her car fixed. She had my mum doesn't use her car very often. So when she does, the brakes were squeaking. So it was just dust and grime on the brake discs and stuff. So they cleaned that for her. But that was his trip out today. Hi, Helder. How's it going? How's Oban today? Has it been as hot as the UK today? You went through the Panama Canal? As well as going from San Diego to Norfolk on the last ship I stationed on. Oh, Ed, that sounds amazing. Wow. I mean, I'm looking at this map now, just of the west coast of America and Las Vegas. And, like, it's to me, it's names. I've heard of Thousand Oaks. I've heard of Pasadena. I've heard of Glendown. San Fernando, obviously. Malibu. Santa Monica. Inglewood. These are all names that, again, pop culture I've been brought up with. Reseda, Encino, Fresno. See, this is me. You remember they went for a state where people were watching the Blair Witch Project, and they went to that town. I can't remember the name of the town where the Blair Witch Project was supposedly set, and they were stealing the signposts. that's the sort of thing I'll be doing. Never rent your house to a film company. They'll destroy it. Most homes used in films are usually not lived in. Oh, my God. I could believe it, though, Phil. I mean, that house from Home Alone. I always see it. I mean, I think it was up for sale about 3 or 4 years ago as well. But, you know, if you plan to continue living there, I bet that's something that you've got to keep your mind on. When you fly, don't sit near the window. You might see the wing creature on the wing. You're talking about Twilight Zone. I love sitting by the window. If I'm sitting by the window, I can see that the plane's still moving, so we're all happy. Hey, my brother Russell. We were talking about Portsmouth just a second ago. Did you see the NFL games that are coming to London, if anyone's into the NFL? So I think we're going to all three of them, hopefully. One of them's on the 30th when I got the kiddies. So we've got the, let me think. We've got the New York Saints are playing the Minnesota Vikings. And that's at Tottenham Stadium. We've got the Green Bay Packers and the New York Giants at the Tottenham Stadium. And at Wembley Stadium in October 30th, I believe, we've got the Jacksonville Jaguars and the Denver Broncos. There you go. Three games this year. Looking forward to that. Going to be pretty amazing. It's grim. Oh, well, we had lovely weather when we were up there. I'm sure it'll come back. We're coming back in August, remember, Hilda? So I'm sure the weather's going to get hot again there. Road trip, definitely a road trip. In the film Tommy, when he was sitting on the roof, that was on Hailing Island. Really? Look, all my Portsmouth peeps are coming in tonight. My brother Russell's in. John, you're in. Wow. You simply cannot go to California without visiting Yosemite Valley. It's simply the most beautiful place on earth. I've never heard of it, Kevin. But that'll be another thing that I'm adding to the list there to read up about. Wikipedia is getting exhausted by my travel thing. The house from Ferris Bueller went on for sale. Let me read that. Hang on. The house from Ferris Bueller was up for sale for ages, overdue due to being famous, went for half the price in the end. The draft, you know what? I managed to get an hour into the draft on the, was it the Friday night, Thursday night? I can't remember. And I fell asleep, unfortunately. But I'm looking out for the Seahawks this year. They had a bad time of it. And I know our good friend Darren there, he's probably been kicking himself. I'd like to see that they're not going to end up like the Jets in our division. but the tickets for the NFL, just so you know, go on sale in June for us, unless you are a Tottenham season ticket holder or you're a Wembley club card member, in which case I believe you can get tickets for the end of May. But yeah, I like a good American football game. Shame the Rams aren't coming over this year, but I'm rather partial to the Denver Broncos, I have to say. Last week was very good, but I think that was the summer in sunny Oban. That's all you get, is it? It is after the first round. You don't want to watch it anymore. But Jack's got me into this John Madden game on the PlayStation, so I've been playing that. But it's weird. I said I'm Australian. I support Arsenal soccer team, but I don't really follow football that much. I follow American football a lot more than I do British football. So very strange. How far is the Selfie Stadium? Hey, Wayne, did you get any more kits for the Ecto-1? I've had nothing. We had kit 34, Michael, which was the rest of the gurney. Let me show you what it looks like there. And obviously, we put the first light on, which is incredibly loud. I tried to do everything I could to get that quiet. I put grease in it. Someone suggested putting some cloth at the bottom to dampen it. I've actually got some rubber. Which is really tiny. It didn't do a thing. Didn't do a thing. So that's really loud. And then when we put the back sirens on in the next stage, it's going to be in stereo. Bearing in mind, we've only got like 2.5 stages left of that build. And then that's finished. Can you believe that? Crazy. Mrs. Doubtfire's house. Now that's in San Francisco, isn't it? Was priced in the millions. Don't think they sold it. You've never been at an NFL game. I like the brutality game, like metal music. I learned something. The first one I went to, I think it was the Miami Dolphins and the Giants or Jets. The first one at Wembley, I'm sure it was the Jets. It could have been the Giants, one of them two. But I learned that if you sit really low down, like horizontal to the pitch, obviously you're closer to the action, but it's harder to actually follow the game, I found. So I try and sit up quite far so I can see down onto the pitch. And our seats that we had at the Tottenham Stadium was amazing for the Jaguars Miami Dolphins game. Jack didn't like it because obviously he's a Dolphins fan and they lost in the very last kick of the game. But that was last year. The Isle of Man TT. DRN, I've seen some footage from that. You've got to be taking your life into your own hands doing that. Not just as a cyclist, but for as a motorbikist, is that a word? Motorbikist? But as a spectator as well. I think I'd be too scared to even watch the thing. Ah, Sheldon, that's good news. Sheldon ordered the blueprints, team. You ordered the decals for the Bismarck. You sent me the blueprint and the stand. Wow. Well done, Ian. I'm on the stage when you put the tall lights on. What? Michael Glogg. I'm sorry, I've lost my standby. Anyway, did you? Oh, right, yeah. Okay, I understand now. Is it? I didn't know that. I think Jack wanted to be out in Miami. I think he had plans to be out in Miami this year, but I think he wants to get out there. Any given Sunday, eh? Any given Sunday, I can lose a game with the Seahawks and end up having to shell out for a championship Seahawks cap. I wish I had that bet this year, Russell, I'll tell you, because, like, you know, the Seahawks had a mare. I felt so sorry. You probably noticed on our little chat we had, I kept quiet because it's not good when they're not performing at all. But you never know. New season. Pull your socks up and see how we go. I mean, how are the Chargers getting on? See, Phil's a Chargers fan. So, you never know. This might be their season, Phil. I'm wishing for you. This is really nice ale. I'm starting to see the dots. The dots are starting. Mark, the Knight Rider build. When I go on to the tracking of Fan Home, it just says out of stock. Now, I believe we're all on the same one, aren't we, at the moment? We've just done the turbine and we've done the vent for the turbine. I don't think I've seen anyone pass that. You'll have to let me know, but I haven't received anything. Although, saying that, I did have a Fan Home notification today, but I think that's the R2-D2. So we'll have to see. But it's all good. Silverstone's just down the road for me, Philip. We're about 40 minutes from Silverstone here. In the when we came back from... was it Wales? Yeah, when we came back from Wales last year, We drove through Silverstone when the Grand Prix was on, but because everyone was at the Grand Prix, it was completely dead. Take care, John. See you later, mate. Oh, sorry, Raymond. We talk about everything on a Thursday night. You haven't had any R2 parts in 2 months. Yeah, I think they're on the way here. But to be honest with you, Roy, I can't vouch for America. I don't know. No idea. Hopefully, things will start getting back to normal. Now some of you are starting to get your deliveries out there. But we'll have to see. We'll have to see. Definitely. But you want to visit a 24 Hours Le Mans one day. That could be a fun race. What about the Paris-Dakar? Did you see Charlie Borman, after he did the long way round, he did the Dakar rally. He entered it, and I think after the first week or something, he broke his hands. But that's a fun one. Van Hoen was moving to a new warehouse in March. Oh, no. Have we ever heard that before? Take care, David. See you later, mate. There you go. It's 9 o'clock. That's gone quick. So remember, there's going to be no... there's going to be no video on the channel tomorrow. The next video on the channel is going to be Saturday, and it's going to be Mrs. World of Wayne. It does mean that I've now got space in the schedule to actually get a Volvo video out next week, finally. So we'll be able to do that. So that's going to be out probably next week. We're still going to keep Wheelie Wednesdays, though, for the Ducati. And as I said, there's going to be no stream on Tuesday because I'm off to see Doctor Strange doing something in a multiverse of madness. It's all good. Anyway, I'm going to finish my hour. Take care of yourselves. See you later.